presidential candidates, and Donald Trump and Joe Biden, as expected, are the winners. No one was running against either of them of any consequence. Locally, the big story, and we talked a lot about it in the run-up to yesterday's elections, was the $252 million referendum for Milwaukee Public Schools. We had all the candidates on both sides of the issue, pro and con, and voters yesterday approved that $252 million referendum. The referendum passed 51-49. Now, this was interesting. You were here late last night watching this, and I was at home watching it on my computer. And like 11 o'clock at night, it still had not been decided.
Neck and neck. It was so close. I thought it was just they were going to do a recount. I didn't know what was going to happen. When I left at 10:30, and I'm like, what is going on?
And it was within a couple hundred votes, and actually no votes were leading. And it was within a couple hundred votes. And then a bunch of votes came in. There was absentee ballots that had not been collected. There was a thumb drive from one of the wards that had not been inputted. And when that ended up being put in, the yes votes prevailed by 1,720 votes. More, a lot more than I think anybody thought, because as you were here all night, it was like, this is so close. This is so close.
201 votes was the closest it got. Man, it was so close.
And it passed by 1,700. So Dr. Keith Posley is the superintendent of Milwaukee Public Schools. And he spoke today, and his basic message throughout was that this is going to increase the number of referendums in our state if we don't come up with a way to fix the funding methods for schools in Wisconsin. This is Dr. Posley.
For 16 years, the state of Wisconsin has failed to adequately fund public schools. So schools will need to continue this whole referendum cycle again and again if there's no change.
The superintendent did extend an olive branch because there were groups and groups and groups that were opposed to this referendum, including the Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce, who will join us later in the show. And Dr. Posley offered to collaborate with those groups as we move forward.
Today, I'm calling on those who opposed our referendum, those who stood opposed to providing our children with what they need. We come to the table. We're ready to work with you together to see what we can do to make sure that our children are successful.
So MMAC was against the referendum, and they released a statement today saying, now that the referendum is passed, it's vital that Milwaukee Public Schools use these additional resources to improve student outcomes. It's important that the MPS plan be transparent and bold. The status quo is unacceptable, and a strategic plan is better equipped MPS students for the workforce of tomorrow, and that is essential. And then they said basically that they will work with MPS. So the president of the Teachers Association said that MMAC was extremist. Dr. Posley was asked about that today.
A union president called the chamber of the MMAC, which opposed the referendum, extremist. Do you think the MMAC is extremist like she said it was?
My goal here today is to thank the individuals in the city of Milwaukee for the overwhelming support for our children.
Would you condemn those words that they're extremist?
Just like I shared with you earlier, and the answer won't change. I just share it with you. My goal today is to support our children. And my goal every day that I wake up is to support our children. I can't get hung up on who says what or whatever the situation may be.
MMAC, the president, Dale Coinga, will be with us in the studio coming up during the 4 o'clock hour. And you can bet we're going to ask him that question because he's the one that was called extremist. MPS Board of Directors President Marva Herndon says the district is not done needing funds.
I found it difficult to imagine reducing or removing the curriculum and services that we have worked so hard to put into our classrooms and provide for our students with the funding that was received from the referendum in 2020. Are we done? Absolutely not, because then came COVID. So we are not done. We've got a tough road ahead of us, and we know that.
Former Lieutenant Governor Mandela Barnes tells WTMJ exclusively why the state refuses to fund schools is beyond him.
You look at the breakdown of the vote. It was not an easy decision for people to make, but they made the decision to fund our schools. It is up to leaders in the legislature to do the same thing, to step up and allocate the resources that are already available. As I mentioned before, we are running a surplus. There is money to fully fund our schools across the entire state. Why the legislature refuses to do it is beyond me.
Barnes also said he empathizes with childless Milwaukeeans who are skeptical about the referendum.
Myself, a childless adult, I do see the importance of making sure that we have people who are trained and ready to enter the workforce, people who are ready to be productive members of society. That's what it comes down to.
Wow. Lots of people with lots of opinions today. The day after the referendum passes, 51 to 49, residents will pay $216 more in taxes for every $100,000 of their home's value. So that's a lot of money. You have a home that's a $200,000 home, which is not a fancy home, you're going to be on the hook for $432 more dollars in tax. And if you rent, your landlord is going to pass that on to you, because if you're in a unit, if you're in a building that has 20 units in it, that tax on that building is going to escalate, and that's going to get passed on to you. Your rent is going to go up as well. So much more on the referendum issue as we head deeper into the show. MMAC President Dale Coyne, who's been called extremist on this issue, joins us at 4:46.
Posley seemed extremely energetic
and
resolute.
Yeah, especially on that question. Yeah. In Madison, they had actually a bit of an issue at the polls yesterday.
That's right. A Dane County judge had to extend the hours of a polling location to 9:30 last night. So the polls are supposed to close at 8. Everybody knows that. Voters who were going to their correct location to vote at UW-Madison's Memorial Union, everybody knows that location in Madison, if you're familiar with it, but they were told there was no voting there at all. City of Madison attorney Michael Haas told me over the phone today, it was a student who reached out to his office at about 5:10 last night about the problem. And that student, John, happens to be a city alder, Govan Deroshan.
The alder indicated to the judge that if he were a normal student, he probably would have just walked away. But knowing more about how elections work and government, he started asking questions and learned that the front desk staff had been told to tell people that voting was not taking place there, and the vote here signs were apparently turned around so people could not see them.
Which is kind of odd. So how do you get a hold of a judge after hours at 5 at night to fix all this in the first place? They have one on call, apparently, in every municipality for election emergencies like this one.
I mean, I called the number, the judge answered the phone, I explained the situation, and that I wanted to contact the attorneys for the Republican and Democratic parties to see if they agreed, and the judge said he would sign the papers unless there was an objection, and if there was an objection, he would hold the hearing, and so that's what we did at about 6:45 last night, and he granted the order shortly after 7 o'clock.
So what was the cause of all of this? There was early voting in the weeks leading up to the election at this spot, and apparently it was human error. It got mixed up by one person telling the next shift there was no voting there that day. So it's human error. He said people make mistakes, but it is not known how many people were turned away. We do know that from 8 o'clock to 9:30, 9 people voted between that time that night. So I don't know. Every vote counts.
And that raises a very good question, because if you showed up there earlier in the day and you were told it's not open and you're like, this is my polling location, I don't know where to go, I don't know what to do, and you're on your way to work or you're on your way to get your kid from daycare, you're probably not going to go back between 8 and 9:30. Some people may, but for a lot of people, that will not work. They've planned out, we all plan out our days.
Yeah,
so if you're turned away earlier, yeah, I tried. Sorry. I guess I'll figure it out next time. You're not going to go back home, most people, after eating dinner, trying to get your kid tucked into bed, whatever you're doing, and go back to the polling place.
It was all the way in the back of the building by the lake. So, yeah, there's no way you could even see it unless if you really knew and had known that before.
So many are saying it's a problematic location all the way around. Like you said, it's the back of the building. There was not signage. According to many witnesses, there was no way of knowing that that was a place where you could vote. That building is huge. It has many entrances. Tough to navigate if you're not familiar with it or you're voting for the first time. Not enough staff in place. The union as a polling place without adequate staffing, probably not a great polling location. We've got more on the election, the aftermath, as we head through the rest of the afternoon here on WTMJ. During the 4 o'clock hour, Peter Barca, you know that name. He's a former U.S. congressman. He's a former leader in the Assembly. And he is the current Department of Revenue Secretary. He's thinking about running for Congress again against Brian Stile. Peter Barca is with us live coming up at 4:15 on WTMJ. Business headlines on this Wednesday. Linda Spice is at the Milwaukee Business Journal.
Milwaukee chefs Dan Jacobs and Dan Van Wright of Esther Ev Restaurant advances nominees in the 2024 James Beard Foundation Awards. The duo is recognized in the Best Chef Midwest category and also co-owned Dan Dan Restaurant in Milwaukee. Jacobs is also a competitor in season 21 of Top Chef. Eagle Park Brewing and Distilling announces that it will open a new Milwaukee Brewing Company taproom in Milwaukee's Bayview neighborhood in May. The taproom will replace Tonic Tavern, which closed in February at 2335 South Kinnickinnick Avenue. Concordia University files a mass layoff notice with the State Department of Workforce Development. Concordia stated that it would lay off 24 employees around the end of May. Staff cuts will take place at both of Concordia's campuses in Wisconsin and Michigan. I'm Linda Spice with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
Milwaukee's finest hotel, the Pfister Hotel, is continuing with renovations to enhance its already stellar reputation. Phase two of the renovations is in progress to transform the hotel's historic rooms, with many new rooms available now for reservations. Phase three will focus on the hotel's public spaces, set to be completed this summer. The renovations will blend exceptional comfort with cutting-edge technology, reinforcing the hotel's approachable sophistication. The Pfister is ready to welcome you for your next visit. Start planning your stay today at thepfisterhotel.com.
Otto's Wine and Spirits, it's Rush Shop. Probably literally every week I'm in there. Wine and Spirits, employee-owned, friendly staff, 7 locations throughout the metro area. I go to the one most often in Menominee Falls, but they're all over the place. One of the things I love about Otto's, they've got the greatest selection. They've got a helpful staff. They know exactly what they're doing. Huge selection of seltzers, ice-cold beer coolers, and they've got great wine club specials. I'm in their email wine club. Here's how it works. I signed up and it's free. They send me an email about every week to 10 days. It's got a great wine offer, and I can choose to buy the case of wine or I cannot. I'd say probably half the time, literally, I buy the case of wine because it's a great, great deal. Open 7 days a week in addition to my place in Menominee Falls, Otto's in Milwaukee, Elm Grove, Brown Deer, Cedarburg. They're going to take great care of you. Best selection, best service. It's Otto's Wine and Spirits.
Outdoor living is great, but it's best when it's at your own home. Well, there's a company called Outdoor Living Unlimited that will build you a deck, a patio, pergola, fire pit, all manner of things to enhance outdoor living at your place, even an outdoor kitchen. Get started right away. Contact Outdoor Living Unlimited now. Get your yard project onto Outdoor Living Unlimited's calendar while there's still openings. OutdoorLivingUnlimited.com.
We all share the same roads, but when an accident happens, we don't always share the same consequences. Big trucks can cause big damage. Injuries can be severe and may require a lifetime of care and compensation. Call Gruber Law Offices today. We can help you from the safety and comfort of your own home. Our virtual sign-up process is quick and easy. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scafitti for the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products along with a world-class customer experience. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and so much more. Every unit is custom-built. Elevate your bathroom to a new level of luxury, style, and safety. Schedule your free in-home estimate today and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
At the Bath Authority.
You can't beat Burkhart.
Sports lovers love us.
Annex Wealth Management. Investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning from a fee-only fiduciary. Forgive commission sales pitches and financial products you don't need. Know the difference. Annex provides elite, comprehensive financial planning customized to who you are and what you need. AnnexWealth.com.
Get started with your no-hassle refi checkup by clicking on the blue button at Acunet.com.
Traffic is sponsored by COWAL Investment Group, the retirement specialists. Retire well with COWAL.
When was the last time you had a second opinion on your retirement plan? If you have $750,000 or more, schedule your retirement review with one of our fiduciary advisors at thecowalway.com.
Giannis into the front court. He spins into the paint. Lays it in with a right hand. That was a fiendishly good move.
Tonight, the Bucks defend Milwaukee from a grizzly bear attack. Our coverage of Bucks Grizzlies starts tonight at 6 on your home of the Bucks. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 4:01. I'm John Mercier. This is Wisconsin's Afternoon News. Your top story, a crash ends with a six-year-old in critical condition.
I'm Julia Fellow. Updates on the human leg found near Lake Michigan.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. And on the off-ramp to Howard Avenue from 4394 northbound, we do have a crash there. So watch out for that. We've also got an issue, broken down vehicle on the exit to Lincoln Avenue from 894 southbound. Beyond that, stays heavy all the way down and around the hail interchange. We've also got westbound 94 slowing from 16th Street all the way to Holly Road. Eastbound, heavy out of the Zoo interchange all the way to about 35th Street. And then on southbound 43, heavy past Capitol and then back on the brakes from North Avenue down through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, rain snow mix continues and breezy, a low of 35 degrees. Tomorrow, scattered rain and snow showers, windy, a high of 42 degrees. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, a six-year-old is in critical condition after a car crash near Cleveland Avenue and 27th this morning. Milwaukee police say a silver Nissan ran a red light and struck a blue Dodge. A six-year-old passenger in the Dodge was taken to the hospital. Police arrested the 34-year-old female driver of the Nissan. Charges are pending.
Updates from Cudahy. After a human leg was found near Lake Michigan at Warnemont Park, east of the golf course by the pump house, the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office confirms the leg is from a human and investigating this as a death, not a homicide. A resident going for a walk in the park saw it, called 911 Tuesday evening after discovering it.
While city residents approved the Milwaukee Public Schools referendum, supporters acknowledged the vote could have gone either way.
The $252 million referendum passing by a razor-thin margin Tuesday. Former Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor and vocal referendum supporter Mandela Barnes tells WTMJ he understands the concerns of those without students in the district wondering how the referendum affects their lives.
Myself, a childless adult, I do see the importance of making sure that we have people who are trained and ready to enter the workforce, people who are ready to be productive members of society. That's what it comes down to.
In Milwaukee, Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
The Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce opposed the referendum. Their leader, Dale Coinga, joins us live coming up at 4:45.
34,000 We Energies customers still without power at this hour. Our messy spring weather is to blame. Most are in northeastern Wisconsin. Meanwhile, an overflow alert from the Milwaukee Metropolitan Sewerage District. Because of the heavy rains and snow, the Jones Island Water Reclamation Facility is at 100% capacity. MMSD recommends limiting water use to prevent the risk of basement backups and sewer overflows. This includes not washing dishes or laundry and taking shorter showers.
A Top Chef contestant named a James Beard nominee. Milwaukee chefs and business partners Dan Jacobs and Dan Van Wright advances nominees in the 2024 James Beard Foundation Awards. Our partners at the Milwaukee Business Journal report that Jacobs and Van Wright are recognized in the Best Chef in the Midwest category for their work at Esther Ev. Duo also owned Dan Dan Restaurant in Milwaukee. Jacobs is currently competing in Bravo's Top Chef TV series, which taped its season 21 in Milwaukee. Winners will be announced on June 10th.
This afternoon, Milwaukee County Parks will open its beer garden at South Shore Park and announce a partnership on a fundraising initiative with Miller Coors.
The 153 parks and more than 15,000 acres is a lot to maintain.
We can do different things with the existing acreage.
County Parks Executive Director Guy Smith on Wisconsin's Morning News says the parks do need more funding, but they are also looking at ways, if not to downsize, to smart size.
Is there infrastructure that we don't need? We tend to have a lot more asphalt than we should. So what we've been trying to do is convert some of our parkways to trail. Certain areas that should be naturalized don't necessarily need to be mowed turf.
Vince Vetrano, WTMJ News.
Coming up, a major Brewers anniversary.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 4:05.
Discover Pella now, pay later at PellaWI.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
When you see our selection of gently worn brand name girls and women's clothing, you'll love what you find and you'll love the prices. So low that you won't believe your eyes. At St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores, you'll find something cute, maybe a whole new outfit for so much less. Gently worn brand name clothing at far below retail. You're gonna love it. On Highway 100 at Layton and Greenfield and 23rd and Lincoln in Milwaukee.
Ooh, you're gonna love it. St. Vincent de Paul.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to work in the yard, tackle a project, or enjoy family time, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $10 Blaine's gift card with a $100 purchase of Estate Fertilizer. Men's and women's Carhartt Pocket Tees, 2 for $30. 15% off Gardner Bender electrical tools and supplies. And save $50 on select Basement Watchdog backup sump pump systems. We get you outdoors because we get you. At Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time 407.
This season marks a major anniversary for Brewers principal owner Mark Anastasio.
This is season 20 for me and our family.
And since that time, much has changed, both on
Prince Fielder, Ricky Weeks, Corey Hart, and Brian Braun actually wasn't, when I was looking at the team, he was our, Doug Melvin picked him in 2005.
And off the field.
Starting with American Family Field now and the terrific public-private partnership we have, and we know we'll be here for decades.
That expansion includes the Dominican Republic, where the Brewers opened up their first baseball academy in January.
We have 55 people there, and how proud they are to wear our colors.
Mike Spaulding, WTMJ News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. The Brewers get their first loss of the season, losing 7-3 to the Twins. And the Bucks are at home against the Grizzlies tonight. Coverage begins following the 6 o'clock news on WTMJ.
Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 408.
There are surgeons lining up to be the one to do your joint replacement. But my advice? Exhaust all your options and put off joint replacement as long as you can. Make it your very last resort, because life after joint replacement isn't always what it's cracked up to be. As high as 30% of patients who have undergone joint replacement surgery report unsatisfactory results. And the cost, even with insurance, can be extraordinary. At Rejuvenix, we'll help ease your pain and improve your mobility with FDA-approved pharmacological treatments that precisely target where your pain lives. And by easing your pain and inflammation, we'll help you live a better life. And because we're in-network with most major insurance plans, your out-of-pocket expense could be very affordable, or nothing at all. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenix Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life.
Rejuvenix. Alleviate your pain. Rejuvenate your life.
Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air. Broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, John McCure and Julia Fellow.
Kind of yucky out there. Be careful if you're driving. Leave yourself some extra time. That radar is looking nasty right now. We're excited to be joined in the studio by our friend Tori Lowe. He's the host of The Tori Lowe Show. 1 to 4 on 101.7 The Truth. Tori, how you doing?
Hey, how y'all doing?
And we have Liz, an advocate in the community.
Yeah, I brought Liz. Liz was hanging out with me on the show today.
You brought some extra firepower with you?
She was telling everybody to come out to the cleanup.
Let's talk about the cleanup. Tell us about this, Tori. It's the Tori Lowe Community Cleanup. It's on Saturday, April 13th. Tell us about the cleanup.
Powerful. This is powerful. This is what we do. It's springtime. We got to get out here, working together now, and clean these neighborhoods. We got three locations. If you go to 1017thetruth.com, you can pick what location you want to help out. And you get free cousin subs.
Ah, ooh, like that.
Hey. Can you believe when
powerful?
Can you believe when the snow melts, all the trash that we see?
Oh yes.
Right.
What?
It's crazy. Like along the fences and the tree lines.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
But it's symbolic. It's something that we can all come together for. Mm-hmm. It's something that shows and teaches the young children how to give back without having to, it doesn't get any complicated. It's cleaning up, you know. It's picking up trash off the neighborhoods. And some of these neighborhoods need extra TLC, a little extra loving. And we coming to bring that love.
So do people who want to help need to bring anything?
No.
Just ourselves.
That's it?
Bring a friend. Because, I mean, the more hands on deck, the more garbage we can pick up, the cleaner it's going to be. And I can guarantee you, especially with the children, because a lot of people bring their children out, which I feel really teach, cleanliness. And they have a ball. You put them in the shower after the cleanup, they're going right to bed.
And they're going to be full from having the cousins.
You won't believe what you find. I mean, I did a cleanup on Capitol Drive. I found $5. I found hats. I found all these Walmart bags. I'm like, where are these bags coming from?
One year, somebody bought out a metal detector.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah. Hey.
It's about pride, right?
Yeah.
Get out in our city, clean it up. Let's get ready for spring.
It's symbolic. Yes. It's definitely symbolic. It's springtime. What better to get a bunch of people to get together and get some work done?
Yeah.
And then relax and look back and look at what we were able to do. Help a community, help a neighborhood get cleaner. A cleaner community is a better community.
The spots that you chose, are they meaningful to you?
Oh, well, the first spot is early. You got to get up early for this spot. It's Milwaukee North Division in the 53206. I graduated from North Division.
Salute.
I was handsome. But at the time,
you're still handsome.
I didn't think I was going to come back and be able to affect the community in a positive way. And then now that is going to mean a lot to me because that's a full circle moment for me.
So you dated a lot of girls in school?
I was in church. They told me I couldn't even look at the girls. I was homecoming king, and they said that since I was a deacon at the church, I had to give up the position to somebody else.
Yeah. Hey, I want to ask you, I've been reading that there might be a special guest. Now, I just want to make sure.
What?
That it's not Sherwin Hughes or Ken Harris, because I didn't want a special guest.
Is this like an athlete or something?
I'm hearing a special guest. It's so special. That I don't even know. They trying to surprise me.
It's a surprise.
That's good because then you have plausible deniability because we can't ask you because you don't know.
Well, they don't tell me that. I think that we have a lot of volunteers coming out. And when they say they're having a special surprise, trust me, GKB, The Truth, they know how to make those surprises very special for those involved.
Yeah.
If you want to get involved, it's easy. Go to 1017 The Truth's website. All the information's there, including you can sign up right there. Tori, Liz, it's so good to see you guys. Thanks for hanging out with us.
It's so good to see you, too. Thank you so much.
God bless y'all for having us.
Now I'm going to do my detective work and find out who it is.
And she will, too.
Let me know. The right time.
It's 414 at WTMJ.
Associates, big news. Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Hey, I've got two beautiful dogs, and the dogs are better behaved now thanks to Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. They are awesome dogs. You can have a great experience with better results. It's Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. I tell you what, this is the truth. I went in there. I was like, I don't know. This is really expensive. It's not that expensive, and my dogs are the best they've ever behaved. This is the best money I've ever spent on my dogs, and I started with a free consultation. You could do the same thing at Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. Free consultation, sitmeansitwaukesha.com. That is the website. Check it out, sitmeansitwaukesha.com.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Traffic and weather, Debbie Lozaga. Hey there.
Hey there, John. Well, yeah, we've got one issue. It is on the off-ramp to Howard Avenue from northbound 4394, and it is an accident, so just heads up with that. We've got otherwise delays. Southbound 43 basically backing up from North Avenue down through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. Northbound slow from Fond du Lac Avenue up towards Keefe. Westbound 94 actually getting a little bit better. We're still delayed from 27th Street all the way to Holly Road, but it's starting to open up a little bit. We do have another block of heavy traffic from about Sunny Slope Road all the way to almost to Barker Road. Southbound 894 slowing down from the, looks like from Greenfield Avenue down and around the Hale Interchange to Forest Home. So that's something to keep in mind. Things are backing up still around that area. While you're out navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you do happen to see something we should know about, call the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Tonight, rain and snow continues, a low of 35. Tomorrow, scattered showers, a high of 42. Friday, sunny 44. Saturday, sunny 45. On Sunday, chance for rain, a high of 48 degrees. It's currently 38. Peter Barca is the Secretary of the Wisconsin Department of Revenue, but not for much longer. He's announced that he is going to step away from that position, and Peter's with us this afternoon. It's been a while, Peter. It's good to catch up. Thank you so much for being with us.
Hey, John, always good to be with you. Thanks for keeping your listeners informed about what's going on in Wisconsin. We appreciate that.
Hey, I'm going to start right away with this question because it's the question that everybody's talking to me about when they knew we were going to talk to you. Will you run against Brian Stile for the first congressional U.S. Congress seat?
Well, I've not made a decision on that. It's something I've looked at, and I've had quite a bit of encouragement. And obviously, similar to what we've done here at DOR, I think people really want to see people work together across the aisle and try and accomplish things. I mean, we had just a tremendous legislative session that we just finished, passing like a taxpayer enhancement package. And, you know, we're going to finally have a vapor registry. It's so unsafe for kids, as you know. And also we have, tobacco agents that were approved, which are very important. And we got an organ donation bill to make it easier for people to designate being an organ donor. And, of course, that's very important as well. And, we have a new alcohol bill, a comprehensive bill, which is very important. And, of course, we were thrilled about getting the new share of revenue through. The governor worked very hard on that. So it's great to kind of work with him to create an innovation fund. And so, our pattern has been to work across the aisle and try and get things done. And so that's why I'm at least looking at it, because I think people, want to see that. I served in any elected office. It's always been about trying to help people and get things done. And that's not being done very well at this point in our nation's history.
Peter Barca is with us. Boy, that sounded like a campaign speech. I mean, you rattled off a lot of good stuff there. Peter, when will you decide?
I'm just telling what happened here.
What's the time frame?
I would say in the next couple of weeks, 2-3 weeks, somewhere in there.
What will go into that decision?
Strong here, and we just came back from the Capitol. We're trying to get some funds set aside for the new alcohol bill. We've got like 4 new permits and things of that sort. So we're trying to get the resources to be able to make sure that we have that available for Wisconsin, industry officials. And so I've got to finish that up first, and then I start to give some careful thought into whether or not that's the direction I want to go in. I've not made but something I'm thinking about, but we certainly have a lot of things to finish here first.
Gosh, what a political history you have, though. I think it was last year I ran into you in the Capitol. I think you were trying to pick someone up right at the front. And I said, oh, Mr. Barca, hello. Act 10. My goodness. You're the speaker.
Oh, yeah, boy. That seems like two lifetimes ago.
I mean, there's so much more that it seems like you want to get done. So if for some reason you say yes, you know, what type of congressman do you want to be?
Well, there's a problem solvers caucus, I know. And, you know, when I was there before, I worked across the aisle in a lot of different caucuses, like against unfair mandates and things like that. But, you know, in the legislature, I was very big in Buy American kinds of provisions. We had gotten one provision through for call centers, but I just think we need to do far more. And, focus on people and the challenges they face. Obviously, right now, it's very difficult for people. They need help for their families. We worked very hard to get daycare funding passed and new daycare tax credit passed in this past, 3 month period here. And so, just focusing on those issues that are, tabletop issues and trying to, make sure we stop threats against Social Security and Medicare and make sure people have paid their whole lives into these programs, get their due and stand up against those special interests that are gouging people in too many instances.
Peter Barca is with us. Peter, you've received some high praise from Republicans. Van Wangard described you as a rare breed who can disagree and advocate for your position without being disagreeable. Scott Walker once called you a straight shooter and praised you. Robin Voss, the polarizing speaker in the House, said the governor finally got one right when he selected Peter Barca to run the Department of Revenue. You hear these sort of things, and then you look at the environment we live in. Are you disappointed with the state of politics? You kind of alluded to this earlier, where we are right now.
Well, yeah, there's no question about it. I mean, the state of politics today, the polarization is so cancerous and harmful to people. I mean, people were Americans and were Wisconsinites. Your political party is a vehicle to getting things done. That shouldn't be what drives the issues of the day or dictates what you're going to do. And, the best legislation usually is things that you work together on. I mean, I look at like the bipartisan infrastructure bill that passed. It was a great bipartisan victory that President Biden prioritized. I look at, bills like the CHIPS Act, which is a national security issue. I mean, things like that are just vital to this nation, and there just needs to be a lot more of that kind of effort, and that's what's missing today. All of this political nonsense that people throw around as opposed to really focusing on, issues and the challenges that people face to, support their families and dignity and help small businesses to boost jobs. I mean, we've got a huge jobs crisis in this state and in the country. There's practical solutions that are very clear that need to be implemented.
I think that you may have the stamina still, because from what I remember, you were so fired up that one night when it went through, when all of the senators, the Democratic senators, were in Illinois, and you were trying to get them not to do that when you guys were in caucus. I think that you would definitely enjoy doing that in Washington.
Well, I did it once before. It's been a while, and I just believe in public service, and I've loved my time at the Department of Revenue. We have very dedicated staff that are very mission-driven. Susan Dukes, who's our head of income sales and excise, like to say, we have world-class customer service. Believe it or not, we get 99% approval ratings when we do surveys at the end of providing service to our customer service and compliance lines. And we're very proud of that. And that's the best of public service. People come to work every day to serve the public. And, that's what it needs to be about. And I'm thankful, especially this last floor period, we had a lot of bipartisan bills pass, and that's the way it should be. I just left the speaker's office a few minutes ago, and we're working with him on, trying to make sure the technology is there to be able to implement the new comprehensive alcohol bill, and, that's vitally important. So, That's where I think it's at. And I know that here at the Department of Revenue, my last 5.25 years, I think we've accomplished a lot. I'm just so proud of the people at work here that give their all every day when they get up and come to work.
One more question. Do you still carry around your giant sodas like I do?
Well, you know what? Ironically, I still have a big gulp, but it's usually filled with ice water now. I'm getting
is that what it is?
That
okay.
It's so unhealthy, believe it or not. So I usually will get like mineral water or something from Quick Trip, and then I just keep refilling it all week with just regular water.
Love it.
Peter Barca is the Department of Revenue Secretary. Thank you so much for making some time for us, Peter.
Well, thank you both. Great to hear from both of you. And again, I appreciate you all working so hard to get the word out to people, let them know what's going on. And they should know there's a couple weeks left of tax season and it's going smoothly. And if they need any help, they should never hesitate to Google Wisconsin Department of Revenue Customer Service. And I promise they'll get a prompt and courteous and helpful answer.
Sounds good. It's 426 at WTMJ. John Mercier here from my friends at Dave Drakamp Heating. When you experience temperatures that are, maybe in the 20s or 30s, then it gets up to in the 60s. It's rainy. It's snowy. It's doing all in the same day. It can only mean one thing. You live in Wisconsin, and that prepared you to be ready for anything, because here in Wisconsin, anything can happen with our weather. But fear not. For over 42 years, Dave Drakamp Heating has lived here, too, right by your side, ready and prepared for when anything happens. Spring, summer, fall, or winter, even when they all seem to happen at once, whenever you're experiencing a home comfort dilemma, just call Dave Drakamp Heating. From free estimates for new equipment, routine maintenance to ensure your system is ready for anything, or because you have a question about your home comfort, get in touch with the teams that I trust at Dave Drakamp. They've been coming to our house for more than a decade. Dave Drakamp Heating, because your comfort is their family's tradition. They're the real deal. They've got the best team of people. I know a lot of them. They're going to take great care of you. Check out the website, DaveDrakamp.com. You can Google that, DaveDrakamp.com.
Hi, I'm Mike Anzi from Anzi & Associates. We're passionate about continuing on our mission to help more Wisconsin businesses create more success. If you have any questions about our insurance products or just want a second opinion about your insurance or employee benefits, I invite you to check out ANSI.com, or better yet, give us a call at ANSI & Associates. And let's have a conversation about your business and how we can help you secure, protect, and grow your version of the American dream.
Gene Miller here. Springtime, better start thinking about those home improvement projects. Now's the time to call my friends at Hometown Windows and Doors. Update your home's curb appeal and build equity with energy-efficient replacement windows and doors from brands like Pella, Anderson, Marvin, and more. Hometown can also customize your project. They're your local source for wood, vinyl, or fiberglass windows and doors. Stop into their newly remodeled showroom in New Berlin to see the Hometown difference. That's Hometown with an E for your every window and door need. HometownWindows.com.
From big tailgate parties to cozy dinners for two, the freshest ideas start with a stop at Century Foods.
Now through Wednesday, save on 1.38 to 11.36 or 8-count selected varieties, Frito-Lay Lays, Kettle Chips, Munchies, or Bean Dip, 2 for $5. 24-pack Ice Mountain Spring Water, $4.99. 8.2 to 20-ounce selected varieties, C-Pack Seafood, $6.99. 4-count selected varieties, Dan and Greek or Danimals Yogurt, 2 for $8.
Mm-hmm. Why'd you throw my glass across the room?
I have to keep practicing.
The vase from Aunt Sophie?
I'm warming up in case I get to take the mound at American Family Field. Read this.
Win the ultimate baseball fan experience at Century Foods?
You either get to throw out the first pitch, hold the finish line for the famous racing sausages, or be on the field during batting practice. My new TV!
Just doing a little batting practice of my own.
The ultimate baseball fan experience. Return the entry form found in the weekly ad to any Century by July 24th.
Time for the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. Kind of a mixed day. The S&P 500 was up 6 points. The NASDAQ was up 37 points. The Dow on the day was off 43 points. It's a great time for your investment and retirement strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com. Click the Get Started button now. It's Annex Wealth Management. Welcome to our Everyday Health feature brought to you by the Freighter to the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. We all know the importance of wellness and keeping healthy and understand the effect that it has on all aspects of our life. To help us understand how a primary care physician can help us stay healthy and well is Dr. Sabrina Hoffmeister. Dr. Hoffmeister is a family medicine physician who practices at the Freighter to the Medical College of Wisconsin Forest Home Health Center. Dr. Hoffmeister, thank you so much for being with us today.
Yeah, happy to do so.
What role does a primary care doctor play in keeping us healthy?
A primary care doctor plays a very important role in keeping patients healthy. We coordinate overall care, focus on prevention and wellness, identify health risks, track health over time, and act as a resource for all health-related needs. We also order relevant preventive screenings to identify common treatable conditions early.
How often should someone see their primary care doctor, and for what reasons should they plan on seeing the doctor?
Well, this varies depending on a patient's age, overall health status, or if a patient is feeling ill. But for most patients, at least an annual visit is important to make sure preventive screenings and vaccinations are up to date.
What if same-day care is needed?
Our primary care providers do offer same-day care for our established patients, and in the event a same-day appointment isn't available, we also offer many other same-day care options, including a visit in a fast care, retail medicine clinic, within an urgent care clinic, care provided within an emergency department. We also offer virtual visits where the patient can receive care without having to leave home.
What are the advantages of choosing a primary care physician with the Fraidert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network?
We have a great wealth of expertise in our physicians. They practice contemporary medicine and have a unique connection to Eastern Wisconsin's only academic medical center and the subspecialty expertise of its academic physicians. From a convenience standpoint, we are very focused on meeting the patient where they are. With convenient hours, including extended weeknight hours, multiple same-day care options, and many convenient locations.
Dr. Hoffmeister, thanks for being with us today. Find a doctor who's right for you by visiting fraidert.com/doctors.
Traffic is sponsored by TabakAttorneys.com. Veterans benefits denied? Call Tabak for the payback. Brave Americans who served shouldn't be denied benefits or have a disability claim incorrectly evaluated by the VA. If you're one of those vets, call Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 4:30. I'm John Mercure. Your top story and update on a leg found in Lake Michigan.
I'm Julia Fellow, the family of Lakeisha Timmons grieving her death after a shooting.
I'm Debbie Lozaga, northbound on 43, slowing from Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up to Keefe. We've also got the southbound side slowing down right around North Avenue all the way down through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. Westbound 94 is going to be a bit heavy, basically from 25th Street all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. You'll be back on the brakes from about just past the county line all the way to about Elm Grove Road, and on the eastbound side, slowing down from 76th Street through the stadium interchange as well. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Rain, a snow mix continues. Breezy, the low will be 35. Tomorrow, a rain snow shower mix. It'll be cloudy and windy with a high of 42 degrees.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, updates from Cudahy after a human leg was found near Lake Michigan at Warnemount Park, east of the golf course by the pump house. The Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office confirmed that the leg is from a human and investigating this as a death and not a homicide. A resident going for a walk in the park called 911 Tuesday evening after discovering the leg.
Tragedy strikes the mother of eight in Milwaukee on Monday.
Lakeisha Timmons had just finished dropping off her kids at school when she was shot and killed near 18th and Hadley Monday morning. Her daughter, Latinilia Timmons, tells TMJ4 News.
All of our friends was her kids. Any kids who needed somewhere to stay, that was her kids. She had them. She didn't want nothing from nobody. She ain't asked for nothing.
Lakeisha's mother is pleading for change.
I have killed my daughter, man. There's so much violence going on. Y'all didn't put them guns down. There's too much hatred out here in this world.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
This was the 24th homicide of the year in Milwaukee.
The Milwaukee Police Department needs help locating Sade Carlina Robinson, last seen in the area of Commerce and Pleasant on Monday. She's 19 years old, 5 feet tall, weighing 135 pounds, with black hair and brown eyes. She was possibly wearing a black coat, white hooded sweatshirt, blue jeans, and white shoes. Her photo and details are at WTMJ.com.
One day after voters approved a $252 million Milwaukee Public Schools referendum, MPS warns more referenda could follow in the future if the system for funding schools at the state level is not reformed.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
While grateful for the 51% of Milwaukee voters who voted in favor of the referendum, Superintendent Dr. Keith Posley warns,
for 16 years, the state of Wisconsin has failed to adequately fund public schools. So schools will need to continue this whole referendum cycle again and again if there's no change.
In Milwaukee, Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
More layoffs at Amazon. ABC's Dave Packer.
The latest layoffs at Amazon are in its cloud computing division, known as AWS. The company says it's found job duplications and is cutting several hundred roles in sales, marketing, and global services, as well as a few hundred more jobs in its physical stores technology team. The announcement coming after rounds of mass layoffs in 2022 and 2023 that saw the company cut at least 27,000 jobs. In a statement, Amazon emphasizing it's still growing and is hiring for other roles. Dave Packer, ABC News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. Brew Crew get their first loss of the season, losing 7-3 to the Twins. They play again at American Family Field Friday against the Mariners. We will have the game on WTMJ. With seven regular season games left to play, the Bucks hold a 1.5 game lead over the Cavaliers for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race. But the Bucks are just 18-20 on the road this season. The Bucks are in Memphis to face the Grizzlies tonight. Coverage begins following the 6 p.m. news right here on WTMJ.
Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 436.
The name you know, the name you trust. GrandviewHomes.com.
We asked people why they sold their homes to Grandview Homes instead of using a real estate agent.
Everything they say in their ads is true and then some. Very fair price, no real estate agent fees or closing costs. They even switched the utilities out of your name.
Within weeks, we had closed and couldn't be happier.
Whether you have a hard-to-sell home, want a stress-free sale, or simply need to sell your home fast, Grandview Homes is the name you know and the name you can trust. Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Dr. Michael Nolte. ExpertScape recently named him part of the top 1% of spine expertise in the world. Dr. Nolte has published over 50 peer-reviewed articles in leading scientific journals and authored more than 100 national presentations. They added this MVP specialist for orthopedic, neurosurgical, and spine care because at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
Super excited to be joined by our friend Ann Sayers. She is awesome, and she's sponsored by an awesome website. It's travelwisconsin.com. Ann, good afternoon. Thank you so much for being here.
Good afternoon. I'm so happy to be here.
This is a great topic because it's part of our history. Boy, breweries and brew pubs are big time in Wisconsin, aren't they?
We are basically the center of the beer universe, so I love today that we get to do a little cheers to Wisconsin's craft legacy.
Yes, I love it too. Manitowoc County. What's going on in Manitowoc County?
This is such a fun one. So it's Cool City Brewing. These are flights. They're just how they do things up there. And they're not only for beer. You can visit this brewery in Two Rivers. That's Trivers if you're local. And if you're in the mood to sample a little bit of basically everything, you can start with a flight of drinks. Beer is a great choice at Cool City Brewing. They make beers to please all tastes. But you can also try other things like a flight of craft cocktails, of wine or coffee, if that suits your mood. And for the kids, you can delight in a flight of ice cream float. But that feels like maybe for the adults too, doesn't it?
It does. I like that.
Yeah, and shareable mentality kind of extends to their food menu too. They share in the deliciousness by ordering flights of different styles of mac and cheese, tacos, sliders, curds, skewers, you name it. And then afterwards, since you're there, you've got to go over to the Point Beach State Forest. You can see the beautiful Raleigh Point Lighthouse. It's still in operation. It's one of the tallest and brightest lighthouses in the entire Great Lakes. And then book a room at the Cobblestone Hotel and Suites in Traverse for a place to rest off all those flights of food and beverage.
Oh, that sounds nice.
And more in Vernon County, big flavors and exclusive taps at Hillsboro Brewing.
Yeah, craft beer fans can find Hillsboro Brewing Company's products on tap or in cans at more than 1,000 locations across Wisconsin. But really, you can savor it at the award-winning products right there where they were crafted. That's kind of the best way to do it. So to do that, plan a trip to the Driftless region to visit Hillsboro Brewing Company in Vernon County. Here, the taps pour brews spanning a gamut of flavors, from ales and lagers to sours and stouts. Many of the beers are on tap are exclusive, and they're found only right there at the brew pub. And the Hillsboro Brewing Company also serves up tasty pub-style dishes, so you can choose between chicken sandwiches, burgers, appetizers, creative pizzas. There's actually a Reuben-style pizza, which sounds like something you got to try. And then for another fantastic dining option right there in Hillsborough, you could stop at the La Marimba Nicaraguan Cuisine. It's a restaurant that opened just last year, and that's bringing bold flavors of Central America right there to rural Vernon County.
Oh, that sounds so fun. Ann Sayers is with us. Let's head to Titletown. What's going on in Green Bay?
This is always a fun one. You can head up to Green Bay for a brewing experience and all-around fun at Hinterland Brewery. Begin your journey with a brewery tour. Those are offered on Saturdays. You're going to learn about the beer-making process. You'll receive a souvenir pint glass, and then, of course, they'll fill it up with beer for you. After the tour, settle into their beer hall, which promises an urban but woodsy vibe for you. You can snuggle up by two different wood-burning fireplaces on cooler days, or on the warmer days, they throw open the open garage doors so you get that fresh air.
That's nice.
You can order from, it's really nice. You can order from an extensive list of beers there, including their tap room exclusives, and then you can pair that with their fantastic farm-to-table food. Hinterland Brewery, they pride themselves on making dishes with ingredients sourced from local farmers and producers. And since you're right there at Titletown, you got to go out and check things out. The area includes a multi-acre park that's open year-round. It has games like ping pong and shuffleboard, a really cool, unique playground for the kids. And you're also going to find frequent events taking place there in Titletown. There's, you know, wellness activities, campfire gatherings, concerts, and more.
Ann, are you a beer girl?
I am, yes.
Do you ever take your pup? You have a beautiful pup, by the way, to the beer garden?
Absolutely. That's like one of our favorite things to do.
Me too.
So fun in Wisconsin, isn't it?
Isn't it great? And so many of them are very welcoming to the dogs. They'll bring them a bowl of water and let them hang out there on the patio. I love that.
I live closest to Estabrook Park. Like, the Oak Leaf Trail's right across the street. And my dog will just direct me straight there. First around the pond, and then, Mom, get yourself a drink.
It's a smart
Perfect.
Dog.
Perfect.
Ann Sayers is the travel secretary. For more information on the things we've discussed, check out travelwisconsin.com. Ann, it's always fun. Thanks for spending some time with us.
Awesome, Ann.
Thanks for having me. Thanks.
442 at WTMJ. Dale Coinga, the guy in charge of the Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce, is with us up next.
Stay and play in Lake Geneva, the Midwest's premier golf destination. With 10 challenging courses for all abilities and skill levels, breathtaking views, crystal clear lakes, and rolling fairways. Enjoy an all-inclusive golf getaway with luxurious lodging, distinctive dining, and a relaxing spa. Plan a group golf outing, a corporate event, or a weekend getaway with friends or family. For course information and more, go to visitlakegeneva.com. Lake Geneva, it's always been the place for legendary golf.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokunbo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show. Presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scaviti for Universal Windows Direct. Call Universal Windows Direct today, 414-410-2000. For every two windows you buy, get two free. Buy two, get two. Buy four, get four. Buy 20, get 20. No limits. Plus, they'll upgrade your new windows to triple pane glass for free. Extra protection from the elements. Call 414-410-2000. Schedule your free in-home estimate today. For every two windows you buy, get the next two free. Tell them I told you to call, and you get $250 off your order. Like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
John Mercure here for Annex Wealth Management. Investment and retirement planning is important, but too many people put it off. It's time to have a talk with Annex Wealth Management. Getting to know Annex is an easy thing to do. If it makes sense, you move forward. In a time when insurance sales are disguised as financial planning, working with a fee-only fiduciary is a breath of fresh air. Annex operates as one team. In-house financial planning, investment, tax, and estate teams are in-house. I've dealt with each of those teams. Annex makes it convenient with branches across the WTMJ listening area, and meeting online, that's no problem either. That's where Annex Everywhere comes into play. It's April, and the year's shaping up to be an interesting one between global tensions, market volatility, and that little presidential election. It's time for a seasoned approach for you and your family. Visit AnnexWealth.com. Click the Get Started button today. My wife Michelle and I did this years ago. You can schedule your own appointment there. It's easy. It's Annex Wealth Management. Fee-only fiduciary. It's Annex.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button.
One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Traffic is sponsored by Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Milwaukee Mattress, where top quality mattresses are priced hundreds less than premium national mattress brands. Found exclusively at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee.
Traffic and weather, let's get a look at the roads. Get you home with Debbie Lazaga.
All right, we've got an accident, 43 northbound. That's the Rock Freeway at Highway 164. The right shoulder is blocked right now with a crash, so heads up with that. Other than that, we've got delays southbound 894 from south of Greenfield Avenue down and around the Hale. Westbound's backed up out of the Mitchell Interchange pretty much all the way to about 68th Street. That's through that construction zone. We've still got some delays northbound on 43 from Fond du Lac Avenue up to Keefe. Southbound's just going to be tight right through the Marquette Interchange up to the high-rise bridge. ABRI's on the roads. Report accident slowdowns and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen traffic tip line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Tonight, rain snow mix continues. That system is stalled over Lake Michigan. That means we'll continue to get wet. A low of 35 today. Yeah, the rain and snow continues into tomorrow. A high of 42. On Friday, sunny 44. On Saturday, sunny 45. On Sunday, chance for rain. A high of 48. Every day, below average high temps. Right now, it's 38 and cloudy. Dale Coinga is the president of the Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce, and he is with us this afternoon. Dale, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you. That's some great bumper music, by the way.
Isn't that nice?
Tom Petty shout out.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
Want to start with what everybody's talking about, and it's the referendum. And you guys and many other groups in the city came out and said, you know what, we can't support this, and you laid out a good case why you can't support it. It did pass. What's your reaction now that the referendum has passed?
Let's roll up our sleeves and let's go on to a new day. And now it's reality. Hopefully, Milwaukee Public Schools uses this $250 million to do something big and bold and reform and move the needle. And we're right here willing to work with them. We have worked with them on many different programs, and we'll continue to do that. So the campaign's over. The voters wanted it by a very, very, very small margin, but they want it. And that's the way the process works. And so we're here to keep moving forward. I mean, we want a talented workforce that's able to live a fulfilling, great life in the area here. We want to see students get through MPS and be part of that workforce, part of our community.
What time did you go to sleep last night?
I actually went to sleep before the results were. I went to sleep.
I was going to ask you.
I went to sleep thinking that we were up by 2% when I went to bed.
Yeah.
We just did a family trip, which involved a five-hour time change.
Oh, so yeah. So you're still getting over all that.
Yeah. So I woke up at 3 in the morning, leaned over, checked my phone. I was like, oh, we didn't win.
Well, it was a lot closer than 4 years ago.
Yeah, that's for sure.
It was. Yeah, so 4 years ago, 78% said yes. This year is 51%. So I think we had a really good conversation as a community about affordable housing, about what we want out of our education system. And 51% said let's give them $250 million and see what they could do with it. So we're going to keep working with MPS. We're going to keep our eye on the ball. We have a process. We have a system. And that's the way we work at MMAC. We're not Republican. We're not Democrat. The issue today is different than issue to, I mean, we do what's best for the business community. And so, you know, let's go on, move on, and let's accomplish some good things.
Dale Coinga is with us. Dale, I also thought it was a good conversation for our community on both sides. One person who apparently didn't think it was a great conversation was the head of the teachers union. And she said that MMAC is extremist. Dr. Posley was asked about her comments today. He was asked specifically about MMAC and their position. Listen to this response, then I want to get your response. This is Dr. Posley.
A union president called the chamber of the MMAC, which opposed the referendum, extremist. Do you think the MMAC is extremist like she said it was?
My goal here today is to thank the individuals in the city of Milwaukee for the overwhelming support for our children.
Would you condemn those words that they're extremists?
Just like I shared with you earlier, and the answer won't change. I just share it with you. My goal today is to support our children. And my goal every day that I wake up is to support our children. I can't get hung up on who says what or whatever the situation may be.
So what is your response to the teacher union president saying MMAC is extremist?
Well, people know that's not the case. I mean, MMAC involves both parties. A lot of our members are of neither party. We take positions based on what the business community wants. I know we're not extremist. We're not. And I appreciate Polsey's comments. I mean, he has a board he reports to, and his board is largely controlled by the teachers union. And so they drive a lot of what Dr. Polsey does and his messaging. I work for the board of the MMAC. We are over 2,400 members. Those are big businesses, small businesses. Those are members within the seven counties within Southeast Wisconsin here. And our board is 85 of those members. And those 85 members told Dale Coinga, we want you to go out there and we want you to oppose this referendum for the reasons that we discussed. And that's exactly what he did. It was someone who disagrees with you is not an extremist, whether it be an organization or an individual. These are just conversations that we have in a community. And there's so much we could do in this community. There's so many things. We could have conversations, we could debate, and then we could all roll up our sleeves and get things done together. And I've always had that perspective. I mean, I think combat gives you that perspective. When you serve in combat with people that look every different way and have different opinions, you come back together and you have that American flag on your right shoulder, you get perspective. And I've always had that perspective in my careers. And that's the perspective MMAC has, is it's one flag, it's one community. Let's all row in the right direction. We may have different opinions on how to get there, but we all want the same things. We want to have opportunities for our kids. We want to get to that million-person city that the mayor put out there. Let's do it.
And Superintendent Polsley says he wants to work with organizations like yours. How could you help them?
Well, there's many different ways that we're doing it now. For example, we are doing an automation grant program where we're going into four schools. Two of those are one is private, August Prep. One is Milwaukee Academy of Sciences, and two are MPS schools. That's Bradley Tech and also Obama High School. And what we're doing is providing curriculum, very, very expensive machinery to teach automation. And so we're doing that with MPS. We also do a program called Be the Spark, which we always say you can't be what you can't see. So we give the students of MPS the ability to see careers they're not aware of, and hopefully motivate them and get them interested in those careers. And there's all sorts of other things we could do with MPS, and we'll do with MPS. Some of that we're announcing next month in a big program we're going to announce. So once again, I mean, there's never hard feelings here. Each day is a new day, and public debate is good. And let's try to get that graduation rate up and get these folks a meaningful life that includes learning things and being part of the workforce.
Dale Coinga is the president of MMAC. Want to stay kind of with education, but switch gears a little bit. An interesting Wall Street Journal article saying that Gen Z is becoming the tool belt generation. What's the premise of this?
Well, it's 4 or 5 years ago, there was absolute concern that, you know, the next generation was not going to trades. And it's great to see that momentum changing, because going in the trades, that is meaningful, impactful work that our nation needs, and it's honorable work. And there's no more honor in being an accountant or being a welder or a carpenter. I actually graduated high school. I went into the trades. I was a train wreck of a tradesperson. I hurt myself on a carpenter's crew. I tried welding and grinded like a big gash. So I am an accountant and then a politician and then an army officer and now chamber president, because they kicked me out of the trades. They're like, you do not belong here.
Yeah, so me and you.
Yeah. So, but it's meaningful work. You could make a lot of money doing it.
Ooh, quite frankly, the plumbers make so much. Welders,
yeah,
you were saying.
I would say if you graduate high school and you become a plumber or a welder or a car, and you just follow, you don't fall into addiction, you're steady in your relationships, and you just save, you know, a portion of your money, and it's, you know, usually a company match, you will be a millionaire. You will be a millionaire, and so. I know, you know, one of the local superintendents here, his son went off to school, engineering, and just said, it's not for me. It's not for me. And then became a heavy equipment operator, and he bought a house in Tulsa at the age of 20-something. He's making $85,000 a year. And, like, good for them. Go do it.
College is expensive.
Yeah, it is for sure. I want to ask you about one other thing before we get you out of here. Bucks playoff tickets went on sale today. The Brewers are 4-1, and Milwaukee is named an up-and-comer among best sports business cities for events. What does this mean?
Well, because Milwaukee's awesome. Milwaukee's always been a sports town.
It's true.
It's part of our loot, and we are the smallest team with the Major League Baseball city. I mean, we have the Bucks that is a team that's recognized internationally because the players are international and they're good. You know, we've had NCAA tournaments here. We're going to have NCAA tournaments. So we've been recognized as a sports city. I'm really excited. So one of the things I got appointed to the baseball district board.
Oh, yeah.
And so I'm on that board. And one of the things that we're talking about is to winterize that stadium, which people don't realize, like these big NCAA Final Fours, they need a stadium that big. Or if you look at it, you know, there's a lot of different events that need a stadium that big. And they intentionally made the Fiserv Forum smaller than the Bradley Arena because the economics of that, if you want to have a smaller stadium to pack the house, get the ticket prices up there, I guess. But, yeah, Milwaukee's a great sports city. We're a great art city. We're just a great freaking city.
Yes, so we are.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Dale Coinga is the president of the Metropolitan Milwaukee Association of Commerce. Always great to have you here. Love your energy, Dale. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
4:56 at WTMJ. Here's Linda Spice at the Milwaukee Business Journal.
Milwaukee chefs Dan Jacobs and Dan Van Wright of Esther Ev Restaurant advance as nominees in the 2024 James Beard Foundation Awards. The duo is recognized in the Best Chef Midwest category and also co-owned Dan Dan Restaurant in Milwaukee. Jacobs is also a competitor in season 21 of Top Chef. Eagle Park Brewing and Distilling announces that it will open a new Milwaukee Brewing Company taproom in Milwaukee's Bayview neighborhood in May. The taproom will replace Tonic Tavern, which closed in February at 2335 South Kinnickinnick Avenue. Concordia University files a mass layoff notice with the State Department of Workforce Development. Concordia stated that it would lay off 24 employees around the end of May. Staff cuts will take place at both of Concordia's campuses in Wisconsin and Michigan. I'm Linda Spice with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Business news sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
For over 130 years, the Pfister Hotel in downtown Milwaukee has been delighting guests with impeccable service and luxurious accommodations. Celebrate your next special occasion with a stay at the Pfister. Enjoy fine dining at its acclaimed restaurants and pamper yourself with a service from the Well Spa and Salon. Experience the hotel's afternoon tea program or take in live music with the best views of the city from Blue, the 23rd floor cocktail lounge. There's always a reason to celebrate with the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today at the Pfister. Hotel.com.
Believe it or not, backyard party season is right around the corner. Are you ready? Hey, everybody, Debbie Lozaga here for Comfort Awnings. I can tell you my house it's all set. You see, last year I was able to work with my friends at Comfort Awnings in Burlington to have a brand new retractable awning installed on my home. In less than a minute, I can hit a button and unfurl my awning, and bam, my patio is all set to be a comfortable oasis, ready for cookouts, bonfires, and general revelry at Casa de Lozaga. Comfort Awnings comes out, they check out your home, and helps you choose your custom-made retractable awning. With their huge selection of colors and fabrics, they'll ensure the awning looks super sharp. And right now, Comfort Awnings has a great deal. How does $250 off with purchase of awning or screens until April 14th sound? Yeah, pretty good. Give them a call at 414-AWNINGS or visit comfortawnings.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. If you're like me, my home has become my happy place. It's happier now thanks to CertaPro Painters. They are simply the best in the business. They will take care of the scuffs, the faded colors. They'll make your home a new home, inside or outside. They did the work at our house. It was quick, easy, and so, so affordable. Their estimates are always easy. You get a quote right away. It's simply the best in the business. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi. You can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
The next time you're due for service, visit richlawns.com to schedule an appointment at any of our five conveniently located facilities.
All AAA approved and all staffed by ASE certified technicians ready to serve you.
Richlawns!
For WTMJ contest rules, visit WTMJ.com/contests.
Traffic is sponsored by the Wisconsin State Fair. Wisconsin State Fair has $12 group tickets on sale now. Hurry, the sale ends April 30th. Visit WIStateFair.com to save big for group tickets.
Giannis into the front court. He spins into the paint, lays it in with a right hand. That was a fiendishly good move.
Tonight, the Bucks defend Milwaukee from a grizzly bear attack. Our coverage of Bucks Grizzly starts tonight at 6 on your home of the Bucks. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 5:01. I'm John Mercure. Your top story, Milwaukee police are searching for a missing 19-year-old.
I'm Julia Fellow, a Boyle order in Dane County.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Northbound 43, still tight ride from Fond du Lac Avenue up to Keefe. Southbound has actually cleared up nicely. Still a little bit on and off the brakes, a little bit on 4394 southbound, heading down towards the KK River, though. Westbound 94, slow from 25th Street to about Mitchell Boulevard, with the eastbound side slowing down from around 84th Street all the way through the stadium as well. 894 westbound, as you might expect, your construction zone still all gummed up, pretty much from 27th Street all the way through to about 51st Street. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Painting Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, scattered showers continue, a low of 35. More rain tomorrow, a high of 42. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, the Milwaukee Police Department needs help locating Sade Carlina Robinson, last seen in the area of Commerce and Pleasant on Monday. She's 19 years old, 5 feet tall, 135 pounds, with black hair and brown eyes, possibly wearing a black coat, a white hooded sweatshirt, blue jeans, and white shoes. Her photo and details are at WTMJ.com.
While city residents approved a Milwaukee Public Schools referendum, supporters acknowledge the vote could have gone either way.
The $252 million referendum passing by a razor-thin margin Tuesday. Former Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor and vocal referendum supporter Mandela Barnes tells WTMJ he understands the concerns of those without students in the district, wondering how the referendum affects their lives.
Myself, a childless adult, I do see the importance of making sure that we have people who are trained and ready to enter the workforce, people who are ready to be productive members of society. That's what it comes down to.
In Milwaukee, Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
President Biden and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu will speak over the phone after 7 aid workers with the World Central Kitchen were killed by Israeli airstrikes in Gaza. CBS's Linda Kenyon.
White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre says the president will likely reiterate what he would like Israel to do following its deadly airstrike.
He wants to see an investigation that's swift, an investigation that's comprehensive, that brings accountability. And he wants to make sure that it is made public.
The call comes ahead of what are expected to be in-person talks next week with negotiators about the war in Gaza, a possible ground operation in Rafah, and the protection of Palestinian civilians. Linda Kenyon, CBS News, The White House.
New stops coming from Milwaukee's Hop.
The Hop streetcar will begin making stops at the Couture apartment building this month as residents begin to move in. The Milwaukee Business Journal reports the public will be able to use the Couture's ground floor transit center for the Hop on April 11th. The same day, passengers can use the streetcar's lakefront line for the first time during the week. Right now, at least 60 of the Couture's 322 apartments have been leased. Jack Grau, WTMJ News.
Coming up, 20 years of Brewers ownership.
Signing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 5:04.
The name you know, the name you trust. GrandviewHomes.com.
I'm looking for the fastest and easiest way to sell my home, and I keep hearing one name over and over. So I asked people, why Grandview Homes instead of a real estate agent?
I decided that spending the time and money to rehab the unit and sell it through conventional means was not in my best interest.
Right, you were anxious to sell your place quickly, mm-hmm. so no time for tours, listings, or any of that. What's the process with Grandview like?
The process with Grandview was virtually effortless. They sent someone out the same day. They give you a fair price offer, close quickly, and pay promptly.
Sounds like you'd recommend them.
I would recommend this company to anyone in a position of having to move quickly and with no hassle.
No hassle?
No hassle.
Whether you have a hard-to-sell home, want a stress-free sale, or simply need to sell your home fast, Grandview Homes is the name you know and the name you can trust. We buy every home as is, and you'll get a fair cash offer in just hours. Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano here. We agree, right? Potholes stink. And our recent weather means this could be one of the worst years yet. Johnson & Sons Paving is up to the challenge. This team has over two decades experience. When potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving will patch them up or replace the whole parking lot. Take a look at JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com. Sign a parking lot paving contract before May 31st, and you might just get me out on the job site working with the crew. Find full contest details at WTMJ.com/contests.
Stay and play in Lake Geneva, the Midwest's premier golf destination. With 10 challenging courses for all abilities and skill levels, breathtaking views, crystal clear lakes, and rolling fairways. Enjoy an all-inclusive golf getaway with luxurious lodging, distinctive dining, and a relaxing spa. Plan a group golf outing, a corporate event, or a weekend getaway with friends or family. For course information and more, go to visitlakegeneva.com. Lake Geneva, it's always been the place for legendary golf.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time 506.
MySpace reigns supreme. Facebook enters our lives, and Mark Attanasio makes the purchase of his life.
This is season 20 for me and our family, and a lot of great memories.
September 2004, Attanasio, on behalf of an investment group, puts in a bid to buy the team. Since then, it's been one of the most successful runs in Brewers history.
The 7 playoff appearances, I've been very proud of that many playoff appearances in 19 seasons.
For Attanasio, though, it's not just about on-field growth.
We now have, I think, 500 employees around the world. That's really something I'm proud of.
Mike Spaulding, WTMJ News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. The Brewers dropped 7-3 to the Twins at home today, and the Bucks are at home tonight to face the Grizzlies. Coverage begins following the 6 o'clock news on WTMJ.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 5:07.
This report sponsored by the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network.
A cancer diagnosis shouldn't mean we can't make plans. It shouldn't mean living without joy or optimism. Cancer shouldn't be calling the shots. At the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Cancer Network, we're pushing to put cancer in its place by pulling together teams of leading specialists and researchers who work tirelessly for breakthroughs, who are developing innovative ways to treat every cancer, to treat your cancer. And by providing the largest cancer clinical trials treatment program in Wisconsin, so there are more treatment options and more reasons to be hopeful. So let's keep innovating. Let's keep discovering. Let's push to make every cancer diagnosis a story of survivorship and bring back the lightness of life that cancer takes away. To learn more about breakthrough cancer care, visit Fradert.com/cancer.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air, broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, John McCure and Julia Fellow.
All right, let's get right to it. Charles Franklin is the poll director at the Marquette University Law School poll, and he is with us this afternoon. Charles, good afternoon. Thanks for being here.
Thanks. Pleased to be here.
We want to start by asking you, in yesterday's election, one of the things that jumped out at me was that Donald Trump did not receive 20% of the vote, despite being the presumptive nominee and the only one on the ballot that's still running here in Wisconsin. What do you make about how Trump did in Wisconsin yesterday?
Yeah, we see a little division still within the GOP. It was Trump, at least the last time I checked, had gotten 79% of the vote. So that's 21% going to other candidates. That means that, you know, the divisions we saw in the early primaries are still there. It's only 1 in 5 Republicans that chose someone other than the presumptive nominee, but 1 in 5 is still, you know, a fairly significant amount. Biden had his own split, but it was half as much, with 11% voting uninstructed or voting for what the other candidate on the ballot. So both of them show some factions within the party, but a little more so on the Republican side than the Democratic side.
Big time, Charles. 120,000 people? I mean, this is a spring election. We knew what the outcome is going to be. Donald Trump is going to be the Republican presidential nominee. I mean, even Ron DeSantis got 20,000 votes. We knew he's been long out. Nikki Haley, almost 80,000 votes. What does that tell you?
Well, these are expressions. I mean, there's no question about who the nominee is going to be at this point. But these are expressions of dissatisfaction. Our polling for the last year has shown about 30% of Republicans in Wisconsin with a negative view of Donald Trump. That's declined a little bit in the most recent polling, but it's still a significant fraction. And those folks within the party that don't like Donald Trump are coming out and expressing that opinion in these votes, even though they're voting for people who've dropped out long since.
Was there a big winner yesterday when you look at the elections that took place in the state of Wisconsin?
I it's hard to put a single person as a winner on this. I think for both candidates, they did what they needed. They didn't get a real significant problem anywhere. But I don't think there was sort of an overwhelming picture coming through. I guess the main thing we should mention is turnout was just under 1.2 million. Remember, in 2020, the total turnout was 3.3 million. So that means there are 2.1 million people that are probably going to vote in the fall that didn't vote yesterday. And so as we look at small changes or the tea leaves of who was a little better and who was a little worse, let's remember that 2.1 million that didn't vote are going to have a big say on the outcome in November.
For someone who does the polls like Charles Franklin, like no one else can do but you, taking a look at this, though, isn't that such a great barometer? How about Joe Biden? What does that look like to you?
Well, the uninstructed vote, excuse me, was about 8.3%. The high in the state was Dane County, where it was 14.6. Interestingly, Dane County was Biden's worst county, and it was also Donald Trump's worst county. That 8% here is below the 13% in Michigan and the 19% in Minnesota. So I wouldn't say that it represents any kind of evidence of a growing dissatisfaction with Biden, but it's sort of in line with some of the other post-Super Tuesday states where the uninstructed or uncommitted vote has been below 10%. So again, some dissatisfaction with Biden. People pushing uninstructed were saying, look, we're bigger than the margin that Biden won by. That's certainly true. But it's not a huge groundswell.
A new Marquette University Law School poll comes out tomorrow. Charles Franklin is the poll director. Charles, thank you so much for making some time for us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
513 at WTMJ.
Gives you every possible choice in diamonds.
Welcome to Kessler's.
All of the drama, all of the heart-pounding anticipation, all of the dancing.
Rises up, it's good, and it's good, it's good!
Keep it here on WTMJ for all of your March hoops craziness during every sports update on Wisconsin's morning and afternoon news. Sponsored by Outdoor Living Unlimited. Don't miss a single moment of this.
At the buzzer, got it! Are you kidding me?
All tourney long on WTMJ.
WTMJ's Julia Fellow here for Just Between Friends Milwaukee County. The biggest and best sale for children's items like clothing, shoes, books, baby equipment, outdoor toys, and much more. Happening at State Fair Parks Exposition Center Friday, April 12th through Sunday the 14th. Check it out at milwaukeecounty.jbfsale.com. It's a special pop-up marketplace for families to buy and sell gently used infant through teen, maternity clothing, children's gear, and more. Learn more at milwaukeecounty.jbfsale.com. We're talking about 50 to 90% off the retail price. That's milwaukeecounty.jbfsale.com.
Since 1946, Ansay & Associates has provided insurance to help secure businesses and families throughout Wisconsin. With custom coverage and superior customer service, Ansay & Associates can provide all of your insurance needs. Visit ansay.com today and get a free consultation with one of our strategists. Or come see us in person at any of our local offices. Ansay & Associates, securing and protecting your American dream.
Hey, John Mercier here for Floor Coverings International. They just did the flooring in our house, and it is stunning. Carpet, luxury vinyl plank, in and out quickly. They rolled up with that mobile flooring showroom. Incredible. Came in, walked us through everything. The installation was quick and easy, and it is absolutely gorgeous. FCI, the stars of flooring. Each Floor Covering International business is independently owned and operated. They are the real deal. Go to FCIfloors.com for a free consultation. They'll transform your home. FCIfloors.com.
Traffic is sponsored by Hall Mazda Milwaukee. Visit HallMazdaMilwaukee.com.
Be our eyes on the road. Report accidents, slowdowns, and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line at 414-238-9329.
Traffic and weather begins with Debbie Lozaga. How's that ride rolling, Deb?
They'll still be backed up on 894 southbound, starting from just north of National Avenue down and around the Hale Interchange to about 84th Street. So heads up with that. We've also got northbound 43 backing up from Fond du Lac Avenue up to Keefe. Now, the southbound side's eased up nicely, so that's good news coming into the Marquette Interchange. We also have a crash, though, on 4394 southbound. This is just south of Beecher. Everything is off on the right shoulder. Doesn't look like we're seeing too many delays around that area. Just a little bit of a bunching up there. Eastbound on 94, slowing from about 68th Street all the way through the stadium. The westbound side's backed up from 27th. Up to about Mitchell Boulevard. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. That rain is going to continue mixing in with a little bit of snow tonight and tomorrow. Low of 35 tonight, high of 42 tomorrow. Friday, sunny, a high of 44. Saturday, sunny, still chilly, a high of 45. Sunday, chance for rain, a high of 48 degrees. It's currently 38. On Election Day yesterday, a little bit of a problem at one of the polling places in Madison.
Yeah, a Dane County judge had to extend the hours of a polling location. Something, have you heard of this before?
No.
It usually closes at 8 o'clock. Yeah. All of us know this. It was extended another 90 minutes last night at one location. Voters were going to their correct location. They were trying to vote at UW-Madison's Memorial Union, but they were told there was no voting there at all. They kept getting turned away. City of Madison attorney Michael Haas told me over the phone it was a student who reached out to his office about this problem that he ran into after 5 o'clock last night, and that student happens to be a city alder, Govan Deroshan.
The alder indicated to the judge that if he were a normal student, he probably would have just walked away, but knowing more about how elections work and government, he started asking questions and learned that the front desk staff had been told to tell people that voting was not taking place there, and the vote here signs were apparently turned around so people could not see them.
My goodness, would we ever have even have known about this? So how do you even get a hold of a judge? It's 5 o'clock at night to fix all of this in the first place. Apparently, everyone has an on-call judge for election emergencies just like this one because your vote is so important.
I mean, I called the number, the judge answered the phone, I explained the situation, and that I wanted to contact the attorneys for the Republican and Democratic parties to see if they agreed, and the judge said he would sign the papers unless there was an objection, and if there was an objection, he would hold the hearing, and so that's what we did at about 6:45 last night, and he granted the order shortly after 7 o'clock.
Big question here. What was the cause of all of this? How could this have happened? Apparently, there was early voting at this spot in the weeks leading up to the election. It got mixed up by one person telling the next shift there was no voting there that day. So they're calling this human error. People make mistakes. But, John, it's not known how many people were turned away. Apparently, after the 8 o'clock deadline and it went to 9:30, nine people did vote between 8 and 9:30 last night. So something is always going to come up, he says. And we were able to find out about this. Thankfully, this attorney used to work in the elections office, and he was able to have a template of the paperwork quickly to get it to a judge, because there's lots of language you have to have to get this done.
The investigation continues. Thank you, Julia. 520 at WTMJ. Business headlines coming up in just a little bit. First, a couple of words for Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Bella and Baxter are great dogs, and they're better behaved dogs thanks to Sit Means Sit Dog Training. It ends up I just wasn't a great dog owner. Didn't know how to really train the dog the way they should have been trained, talk to them the way they need to be talked to. I know now thanks to Sit Means Sit Dog Training. The classes are great. They're actually enjoyable. And you can start like we did with a free consultation, sitmeansitwaukesha.com. I trust the teams there. Matt, the owner, and his trainers are simply the best. Contact Sit Means Sit today. You can have a happy, confident, obedient dog. SitMeansSitWaukesha.com.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by Bucks radio voice Dave Kane.
I think that stuff's important for them, but there's also you can't be speaking over the heads of a big chunk of your audience that maybe doesn't know that stuff.
Find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Tax Talk with Straight Talk.
You give and you give. This tax season you get with Straight Talk Wireless. You get a reliable 5G network and unlimited data and a Samsung Galaxy A14 included when you buy an extended silver unlimited plan. Yeah. So you can give your janky phone to your kid.
Yeah! Switch to Straight Talk. Find us at Walmart and StraightTalk.com. For network management practices, visit StraightTalk.com. Device offer ends 4/14/24. Taxes and fees apply.
You can host the best backyard barbecue when you find a professional on Angie to make your backyard the best around. Connect with skilled professionals to get all your home projects done well. Inside to outside, repairs to renovations. Get started on the Angie app or visit Angie.com today. You can do this when you Angie that.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender, NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Something very interesting has emerged from the FDA. They're signing off on the first prescription digital treatment for depression. It's a smartphone app called Rejoin for people who get a diagnosis of major depressive disorder. And we had the chance earlier today to talk to Dr. Jake Behrens with Envision ADHD in Mequon.
How do you think this might work, first of all, if someone's become diagnosed with a major depressive disorder?
Yeah, well, there's been a lot going into what we call digital therapeutics. So basically, think of an app that you're actually, quote-unquote, prescribing to that claims it's going to treat a condition, just as you would prescribe a medication or exercise, a supplement, whatever you're going to, quote-unquote, prescribe. And this is the first one coming out specifically going after the FDA clearance for major depressive disorder. The whole idea here is the trial is coming out is it's not to replace other types of treatments. They did their initial study trying to compare their use of an app that gets prescribed. Your doctor sends it to a pharmacy. The normal run around with insurances, maybe you get approved. They send you a code. You download an app on your phone. And supposedly you go through a six days of the week program that you do some activities on your phone along with your typical medication regimen is what it was kind of designed to do, with the idea of hopefully having, potentially having better treatment outcomes for the major depressive episode that someone might be in.
Dr. Behrens, I think any tool is a good tool. In the world we live in, there's so many mental health issues that we discuss on the show all the time. My question is, could there potentially be some danger here in that people in our digital world think they can get everything solved with their phone and online, that they could think this is a substitute for talking to somebody or using medication?
We don't have FDA approval saying that this treatment treats this condition, but they have to prove it's something called FDA clearance, which is basically say it doesn't seem like it's harmful to people and that it's not actively going to hurt them or make things worse is more what the clearance is about. And that's what they were able to get. Technically, right now, in the trial that they did, it's limited. Obviously, more data needs to come out, but there's no such thing as like the FDA approval of the same level of scrutiny as there is with other types of treatments.
Because it's
even
not
as
a drug.
It was currently done. It's not a drug. It's not something that people are ingesting. So I think the safety of it is relatively low. But I think what it means from the expectations, because even in the trial that was done, which is small, I think it's in 300 some people, if memory serves me correctly, they basically prescribed this, had people use this. They were on medication. They didn't specify necessarily which medications, but it was very limited. You know, people could not have PTSD. They couldn't have any use of other substances. They couldn't have failed more than one medication. They couldn't be on many other medications approved for ADHD. So it was looking at a pretty light kind of major depressive episode person. They had them continue their medication. They had one group use this specific, you know, app 6 days a week, and another group that used something somewhat similar. Well, they're doing some kind of cognitive behavioral therapy exercises, some, you know, kind of like brain training games. They basically give a lot more specifics, and they got reminders to do it. And that's what they went through. And they're following some typical measures of kind of depression rating scores. And again, did it have some improvements overall? Yes. Could they say that it was, did it really separate? It showed some slight differences over that, but nothing that fully separated statistically from at least my initial understanding of it. So the evidence was light at best on it. But also, if you try and translate this into the real world, this was 6 weeks of people using something six times a week on a regular basis. They had, I believe it was weekly check-ins with people from the support staff to go along. And I just think, is this going to translate well in the real world of having what kind of in the digital health space, we kind of refer to as stickiness? Getting somebody to swallow a pill once a day is difficult enough. Getting people to actually get on their phone and go through, let's just say, 20 minutes of an activity, I think is going to be a difficult part. Are they going to be able to get the insurance coverage and be able to recoup? There's a lot of apps out there. Can we say this is completely different than other ones? Not necessarily, but obviously they're investing a lot of money to do these trials with the hope of getting insurance approval so that they can charge large amounts for these programs.
So here's my question, doctor. It's meant to stimulate areas of our brain that are responsible for antidepressant effects. How is that possible in an app? If you could explain.
Technically, if you look at any of these brain training apps, activities, you being in therapy, you doing memory exercises, we've had a lot of kind of neuropsych activities, so to speak, to quote unquote train different parts of the brain. So I don't think it sounds large and exciting. I don't think it's as new as people think that it is. And even there's you going through cognitive behavioral therapy exercise and think about your life, that's going to trigger different neuroimaging studies saying, hey, this is triggering certain areas that these other activities do as well. That's really what those activities are doing. It's not that we're causing this direct, it's not transcranial magnetic stimulation, putting electrical, physically stimulate different places. Can I say that the exact activities that this does is different than other quote unquote brain training things out there? I can't say that.
That is Dr. Jake Behrens. It's 529 at WTMJ. Time for the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. S&P 500 up 5 today. The Dow was off 43. The NASDAQ was up 37. Annex Wealth Management, know the difference.
Welcome to the Knowledge Brokers, weekly feature covering the dynamics of the insurance market and how it affects Wisconsin businesses and folks who live here. Sponsored by the original Knowledge Brokers, R&R Insurance. And joining us today is Jeff Salasinski. He's Vice President of Insurance Operations. Good to see you again, Jeff. We've been talking a lot on the news lately about these huge settlements and jury awards that are happening in court. I know that's something that's on your radar.
Yeah, thank you, Vince. It's great to be here. Business owners and individuals need to know the courts are open. They've been largely closed for a couple of years following the pandemic. You're seeing attorney advertising everywhere. It's attacking virtually every industry. These excessive awards and settlements are becoming less shocking. People are just simply becoming desensitized to some of these huge numbers.
So what's any of that got to do with insurance then?
So both inflation and legal system abuse that we've been speaking of may have already rendered your insurance limits inadequate.
Okay, this is the insurance I have right now. You're saying not enough to cover potential damages.
Correct. You might see one of these big numbers against your company as a business owner, perhaps against you as an individual in an auto accident. If you had $500 or $1 million a couple of years ago, a few years ago, it might not be enough today.
Okay, lots of folks do insurance. Why is R&R Insurance the company to count on?
It's really important to work with an insurance professional that understands these issues like R&R. You need in-depth analysis on today's risks and how they impact your business and you as an individual. R&R can help you make a data-driven decision to make sure the selections you're making are adequate. Today's environment is incredibly dynamic, as we've spoken for on our previous engagements. It's rapidly changing. You need a partner that understands what's going on, what's important, and how you manage risk and finding a solution in this market.
That's Jeff from R&R Insurance. Great info as always, Jeff. More information online at myknowledgebroker.com.
Traffic is sponsored by the Wisconsin State Fair. Wisconsin State Fair has $12 group tickets on sale now. Hurry, the sale ends April 30th. Visit wistatefair.com to save big for group tickets.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 5:30. I'm John Merkier. Your top story, the wicked weather continues for Wisconsin.
I'm Julia Fellow, Molson Coors and Milwaukee County Parks teaming up.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. We've got an accident on the ramp from the Rock Freeway northbound to 894 northbound. It's off on the right shoulder, so just heads up as you're heading into the hail interchange. Southbound side is going to be a bit backed up from before Lincoln down and around the hail interchange to about 84th Street. Eastbound 94, speaking of 84th Street, is going to be backed up from there all the way through the stadium interchange. And northbound 43 slow from Fond du Lac Avenue all the way to Keefe. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
39 degrees and cloudy right now. Rain snow mix continues tonight. Breezy. The low will be 35. Tomorrow, a rain and snow shower mix will be cloudy and windy with a high of 42.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, tragedy strikes the family of a mother of eight in Milwaukee today.
Lakeisha Timmons had just finished dropping off her kids at school when she was shot and killed near 18th and Hadley Monday morning. Her daughter, Latinilia Timmons, tells TMJ4 News.
All of our friends was her kids. Any kids who needed somewhere to stay, that was her kids. She had them. She didn't want nothing from nobody. She ain't asked for nothing.
Lakeisha's mother is pleading for change.
I don't feel my daughter, man. There's so much violence going on. Y'all just put them guns down. There's too much hatred out here in this world.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
A six-year-old in critical condition tonight after a car crash that happened this morning near Cleveland Avenue and 27th. Milwaukee police say a silver Nissan ran a red light and struck a blue Dodge. The six-year-old was a passenger in the impacted car and rushed to the hospital. Police arrested the 34-year-old female driver of the Nissan. Charges are pending.
This afternoon, Milwaukee County Parks opening its beer garden at South Shore Park and announcing a partnership on a fundraising initiative with Miller Coors.
The 153 parks and more than 15,000 acres is a lot to maintain.
We can do different things with the existing acreage.
County Parks Executive Director Guy Smith on Wisconsin's Morning News says the parks do need more funding, but they are also looking at ways, if not to downsize, to smart size.
Is there infrastructure that we don't need? We tend to have a lot more asphalt than we should. So what we've been trying to do is convert some of our parkways to trail. certain areas that should be naturalized don't necessarily need to be mowed turf.
Vince Vetrano, WTMJ News.
After competing on season 19 of Hell's Kitchen and Super Chef Grudge Match, Milwaukee chef Adam Pavlik is taking his talents to another marquee show.
Pavlik will be one of two contestants to compete on Food Network staple Beat Bobby Flay.
In 20 minutes, you have to make a signature dish showcasing this ingredient.
A secret ingredient that only the producers, judges, and Flay are privy to. As for the 20-minute clock...
2 minutes to go get all your stuff. A minute to get any pans even hot. 2 minutes you want to leave for plating. I mean, you're looking at 15 minutes of actually cooking something.
Step one, beat the opposition. Step two, go head-to-head against Bobby Flay.
He knows exactly what he's doing, of course.
Greg Matzik, WTMJ News.
The episode featuring Pavlik will air April 11th at 8 o'clock on the Food Network.
A Top Chef contestant named a James Beard nominee. Milwaukee chefs and business partners Dan Jacobs and Dan Van Wright advances nominees in the 2024 James Beard Foundation Awards. Our partners at the Milwaukee Business Journal report that Jacobs and Van Wright are recognized in the Best Chef in the Midwest category for their work at Esther Ev. The duo also own Dan Dan Restaurant in Milwaukee. Jacobs is competing in Bravo's Top Chef TV series, which taped its season 21 in Milwaukee. Winners will be announced on June 10th.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. Brew Crew get their first loss of the season, losing 7-3 in the Twins. And they play again at American Family Field on Friday against the Mariners. Coverage will be right here on WTMJ. With 7 regular season games left to play, our Bucks hold a 1.5 game lead over the Cavaliers for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race. But the Bucks are just 18-20 on the road this season. The Bucks face the Grizzlies tonight. Coverage begins following the 6 p.m. news right here on WTMJ.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 5:36.
This report sponsored by Pella of Wisconsin. Discover Pella now, pay later at PellaWI.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
Chief Meteorologist Brian Nisnansky is with us on a sloppy, crazy day, Niz.
Yeah, sloppy to say the least, but man, big miss for us for snow here. I don't know, though. I was looking at opening day yesterday. It almost would have been better to be like 10 degrees and snowing versus that pouring rain.
It was bad. What happened? So take us through what happened with the storm that you guys didn't anticipate.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was totally like, okay, so in the last couple days, we went from a low pressure center that was supposed to go across Ohio. Then it was like more like Indiana. And then by the time it started to get closer to us, it became pretty clear that this thing was not only going to cross across like the Chicago area, but then stall out over the lake. So what that eventually did was started us off outside of the heavy, heavy snow. And then all of a sudden we were in the middle of the heavy snow. And then eventually the heavy snow swath set up to the northwest of us here in Milwaukee. But still quite a bit of snow. You get northwest and there's still a good amount of snow. You got El Dorado, which is just outside of Fond du Lac at 9 inches of snow. Beaver Dam, 6 inches of snow. Mayville, 7. Jefferson, 3. I saw Watertown was at, I believe, 4 inches of snow. Here in Milwaukee, just 1/4 inch of snow, and that melted pretty much as fast as it came.
You wish you were back on your cruise.
I do. Oh, man. You know, I came home, and I was thinking I need a vacation from the vacation. And then,
all of a sudden, worked there. It was that kind of vacation?
Well, it's just go, go, go. You know, Julie, she wants to do everything. And then we got to, you know, make sure our parents are happy, the kids are happy.
Yep.
Not much time of R&R.
Julie is a jet setter.
As long as the cocktails are flowing.
Yeah, that helps. Until you get back and your mind is fuzzy and you're hit with a big old storm system. Yeah.
What's going on now? Because it's kind of weird. It's like it's just stalled out.
It has. It has completely cut itself off from the jet stream. So we are dealing with the same system that we started dealing with 36 hours ago. It's now parked over Lake Michigan. It will start to retreat, but not before maybe one more push of snow tomorrow morning. Tonight, maybe just a couple light rain and snow showers. But then tomorrow morning, I do think we get another little swath of snow that moves through, that much of the area may pick up another quick half inch to an inch of snow, including here in Milwaukee. But then it probably will just quickly melt away again. It shouldn't be too much of an issue. Maybe the timing creates a little bit of slush for the morning commute, but it shouldn't be a big deal.
We're so spoiled, Niz, because we had a mild winter. It was easy for the most part. And now we get a couple days that are kind of crappy, and everybody's like, oh, I can't deal with this.
I know. April's the new December. That's kind of been like the trend. not every year, but I would say more years than not, we have had more winter weather, including snow, in April than we've had up until Christmas. That's definitely been a trend over the past decade or so here in southeastern Wisconsin, and hopefully this will be it. I'm not seeing any like big snow in the forecast like down the road. I'm like looking in the crystal ball stuff, like some of the long-term computer models, and there's another system late next week that we'll have to keep an eye on, but as of right now, it looks to be primarily rain. But this time of year, you can't keep it out of question.
Mama Niz won't have to complain about the Racine DPW. Do you remember when she had that video?
What was she complaining about?
She had this home video, and she's just like showing the backyard, and then she pans over, and there's DPW. They haven't gotten to work yet. And you're like, thanks, Mom, for calling me.
Yeah, thanks. Exactly. Yeah, the side roads down there. Yeah, she'll be the first person to complain about that. And then my dad just says he hates the snow track tires in the driveway, which I do too. Like, that's something if my dad passed on to me is do not drive on the snow in the driveway if you possibly can prevent that. Please.
Okay, I never understood that. And then I asked Jason about it, my husband, about your post, and he goes, oh no, you don't want that. It can never come off.
Especially middle winter, you could have those tracks until April.
Hey, lead us through in detail tonight and the next few days, Niz.
All right, sounds good. All right, tonight again, scattered rain and snow showers, not a big deal. Pretty light stuff tonight, 35 degrees. Now, tomorrow morning again, we could get that last wave of accumulating snow, maybe up to an inch in a few spots. Eventually, we melt it away with a high of 42. We completely dry out tomorrow night and into Friday. Partly cloudy Friday, 44. Saturday, mostly sunny, 44. Lakeside, 50 inland. And then Sunday, some rain likely, a high temperature of 44 degrees. Not a perfect forecast, but definitely improving over these next couple days.
Chief Meteorologist Brian Niznanski. Thanks, Niz.
All right, see you guys.
542 at WTMJ.
Throughout history, some people have been born into greatness because of their name or family. Others gained greatness because of their actions. On Wisconsin's Morning News, we celebrate everyday heroes, the John or Jane Doe, who had no idea when they woke up one morning they'd be saving a life. Everyday Heroes, Thursday at 6:40 on Wisconsin's Morning News, presented by Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living, transforming the culture of care.
WTMJ's Julia Fellow here for Just Between Friends, Milwaukee County. It's a special pop-up marketplace for families to buy and sell gently used infant through teen and maternity clothing and children's gear at discounted prices. It's happening Friday, April 12th through Sunday, April 14th. We are talking about 50 to 90% off the retail price. You can learn more at milwaukeecounty.jbfsale.com. That's milwaukeecounty.jbfsale.com.
From big tailgate parties to cozy dinners for two, the freshest ideas start with a stop at Century Foods.
Now through Wednesday, save on 1.38 to 11.36 or 8-count selected varieties, Frito-Lay Lay's, Kettle Chips, Munchies, or Bean Dip, 2 for $5. 24-pack Ice Mountain Spring Water, $4.99. 8.2 to 20-ounce selected varieties, CPAC Seafood, $6.99. 4-count selected varieties, Dana Greek or Danimals Yogurt, 2 for $8.
Mm. Why'd you throw my glass across the room?
I have to keep practicing.
The vase from Aunt Sophie?
I'm warming up in case I get to take the mound at American Family Field. Read this.
Win the ultimate baseball fan experience at Century Foods.
You either get to throw out the first pitch, hold the finish line for the famous racing sausages, or be on the field during batting practice. My new TV!
Just doing a little batting practice of my own.
The ultimate baseball fan experience. Return the entry form found in the weekly ad to any Century by July 24th.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Ryan Stefanchek.
Board certified in sports medicine, physical medicine, and rehabilitation, Dr. Stefanchek specializes in non-operative treatment of the spine, chronic pain, all joints, all musculoskeletal problems, and more, emphasizing holistic care first, with a focus on diet, sleep, stress management, and social connections for a patient's well-being. At Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Hey, John Mercier here for Floor Coverings International. They just did the flooring in our house, and it is stunning. Carpet, luxury vinyl plank, in and out quickly. They rolled up with that mobile flooring showroom. Incredible. Came in, walked us through everything. The installation was quick and easy, and it is absolutely gorgeous. FCI, the stars of flooring. Each Floor Covering International business is independently owned and operated. They are the real deal. Go to FCIfloors.com for a free consultation. They'll transform your home. FCIfloors.com.
Traffic is sponsored by COWAL Investment Group, the retirement specialists. Retire well with COWAL.
At COWAL Investment Group, we've been helping our clients plan for retirement for over 36 years. We'd like to help you too. Visit thecoalway.com or call 262-522-4040.
Traffic and weather, let's get a look outside at our wet roads with Debbie Lazaga.
All right. Well, we do have a couple of issues out on the road. Southbound on 4394, just south of Beecher Street, we got an accident off on the right shoulder. Another one on the ramp from northbound 43, the Rock Freeway, into the Hale Interchange to go northbound on 894. That one is off on the right shoulder as well. Westbound 894 backing up from 27th Street all the way to about 51st. We have that construction going on there. Southbound 894 is also backed up from National Avenue down and around the Hale. Northbound 43 is a bit tight just before the North Avenue curve all the way up past Keefe. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Peter Barca is the Secretary of the Wisconsin Department of Revenue, but not for much longer. He's announced that he is going to step away from that position, and Peter's with us this afternoon. It's been a while, Peter. It's good to catch up. Thank you so much for being with us.
Hey, John. Always good to be with you. Thanks for keeping your listeners informed about what's going on in Wisconsin. We appreciate that.
Hey, I'm
going
to start right away with this question because it's the question that everybody's talking to me about when they knew we were going to talk to you. Will you run against Brian Stile for the first congressional U.S. Congress seat?
Well, I've not made a